Today, on my session, we'll talk and review some cases for the topic why we should think about soft skills. Actually, my topic is called Not by Code Standards Alone. Why do tech specialists should be trained to use soft skills and how to educate a team? My session was intended to be useful not only for management team or any team leads, managers of different levels, but for the people who actually thinks about this career and wants to raise their soft skills and managing skills, how they will interact with people in future. Because when it comes to people management, on the first time, you never know how to react and what to do. So, let's start. Actually, this is not going to be a boring formal speech with the rules of game and list of default recommendations. Here we'll review soft skills, soft skill cases with two girls and their working choices. So I would like to introduce you to two girls and my two heroes to you to describe the cases where lack of soft skills was really crucial for future choices and why we need to think about it right now. Before we meet our heroes, I would like to say that all people from these stories have prototypes. These recommendations that I'll give are real and checked, and I'm still checking that. Some projects actually were suffered. And I think we are ready to start, and we are ready to meet our host, our first hero. So this is Anna. Let's imagine that we are her colleagues working with her on the same product. And from this position, we will see the situation where Anna was trying to use her soft skills and what to do next. Let's talk about Anna a bit. Anna is a very technical person, successful developer working on some NDA system and technical researchers. Let's take a look closer to Anna's story in the average company with the managers who are ready to invest into internal innovations. And before we go to the situation, let's review who is Anna actually. She is a very technical person. She can compile the code in her mind. So just imagine this introvertal technical background. She works on technical researchers, and as I said, she gets used to work more with the code than with people. And her interests are optimization, new frameworks. So in free time, she may learn something new, like. There is a lot of frameworks that you can actually try to use and try to learn. So she found a new way to optimize existing system. This way may decrease the maintenance cost of existing products and help to implement new features faster and cheaper. So we can imagine the value that this solution may bring to us as a company and to our product that we are all working on. Her main focus is to present her solution on internal demo and attract the attention of top management team. Because we remember that even when we find it's something, we need to share it, it with the people and actually gain investment, because it's impossible to build this solution by yourself. And her main focus now, as I said, is to present this solution on internal demo. That's important one. And yes. So let's review how what information Anna will present on management forum and how she tries to attract people at people's attention. So let's take a look into this. What she trying to describe? Disadvantages of old solution. Development process was slow. We lost code standards. So this technical part, one after another. Our tech stack is outdated. Okay. For developers, it may sound really obvious. Okay. This is really disadvantage of the system. But let's remember that she presents it on the top management level. Tons of legacy code. For developers, it may sound, oh, really? Yeah, it's code. How we can do it? We need to solve it because it's really hard to manage it. But for top management team, it's just empty words. And how she tries to sell her solution? Only new framework with up-to-date support. We will spend less time for code. Our architecture will be reworked. We'll add more features. We'll keep X2 live connections. Of course, when we are her colleagues, we understand the solution and we think, oh my God, this is really brilliant. But decision was found against her. Decision that top management found after her review. And the issue is that people she made presentation for actually doesn't speak her technical meaning language. To succeed here, she should get her values that management understands. So let's translate a bit how it should be and why did she fail, actually. Development process was slow and buggy. What does it mean on the more top-level perspective? Expensive portfolio support. It's obvious, it's synonyms, but for the management team that looks from the top, it seems more reasonable and more obvious to invest into. Our tech stack is outdated. We can't attract younger people or we have less diversity at all in our development community. Or we have expensive support, again, because all the issues that she described mean expensive support, after all. We'll write less code and spend less time. When we trying to rework it in the way free money for investments and new products, well, this makes sense after that. And the last but not the least, architecture is reworked, as we said. What does it mean from the higher perspective? It means that customers will have a better experience. When customers will be satisfied, we'll attract more attention to our product, we may gain more money, sell this product to wider auditory or something like that. So again, for the top management team, it seems it's free money. So what I would like to say in this story, to set up a new project, to attract attention, to get an internal investment, what we should do? Speak the same language the decision makers speak. But that's not the last slide of our presentation. There will be a lot of cases, so stay with me. And after that, I would like to share with you some of my pains that maybe you had the same experience in this case, and you may see Anna in yourself or had experience with the same Annas on your work. How much these failures may cost, not only for Annas, but for people who work with Annas or who have this Annas on the work. We may lost personal idea after unsuccessful presentation. Just imagine, idea was really brilliant. It was not well presented, so we lost it. We may lost team member that was frustrated after this presentation and didn't want to continue or thought that all the people around him is really dumb and can't understand the benefits, something like that. Innovation flow in the companies where these ideas are lost is slower. It means that it takes more time to finish some feature. It means that the final product will cost more from the development perspective. And in final, it means that as a company, we may fail. And the last but not the least, when we speak on different languages, on the development level and on the management level, it means that some issues on this level may be lost by management level, and it means that management will lost the speed of reaction and actually the speed of fixing it. And it's quite a common mistake, I think, in most of the companies. And let me introduce our next hero, Lily. We are her managers. Let's imagine that we are working with her in some company for a long time, and we know her as a really brilliant developer. She is pretty straightforward, she is pretty focused on the goal, and she knows the system where she works really perfectly, because actually being so technical person and so interested in the system, in the result, in the technology, she implemented most of the features by herself. It happens when you have some brilliant developers who don't like to communicate with other people, just to sit, focus on some task and to solve it fast or with a good code or with any benefit that he or she sees here. And what's important about Lily, that she got used to work alone, supposing that it's faster and more effective. And why we're talking about her? Because one day Lily decided to take a sabbatical. It happens. She suddenly realized that she is a beekeeper in her dreams, and she said to us that already bought a few acres of Alaska's forest to harvest the wild honey. It depends. It also may happen. And thanks to Lily, we got this information in advance and have enough time to hire one, two, or even three developers as her successors. Actually, exactly what we did. So we need to keep system working, and we hired a few developers. We thought that we need not only one but few developers for system support, for new features raising, and actually to reduce the risk on the system when some developer will decide to leave as well. And let's ask herself. We hired these developers and just created a new team. Lily as the team lead, like temporary team lead, and a few developers. Is it easy or is it working? So how Lily works with the newcomers? Here is the result of our actions. Very soon, after Lily got a team of newcomers, we got a conflict there. Lily is angry. Why people cannot get how the system works? It's like a piece of cake to use. Obviously, this is a piece of cake to use for her. Newcomers ask the questions, make mistakes in her perfect system, and after more and more rejection from her side, start frustrating. And she becomes angrier and angrier. What's wrong with our implementation? Let's ask. Actually, the case is that super technical Lily has never shared her knowledge before. She did not plan it, did not use explanation flow from the top management, from the top level to the bottom level. She did not think how to collect this knowledge and maybe to extract it some documentation. All documentation is obvious only for her, because again, she is so super technical that actually she on sometimes she gave up to raise her communication skills. And where is issue in us? We as her managers simply forgot someday to invest into her leadership and communicational skills. It was okay for us when she just simply worked without any additional pushes, and it was fine. It was fine before she decided to leave. And what we need to remember here, that investment into leadership, it's not about raising our own competitors. No. It's about raising technically responsible employees for the knowledge they have. I'm not trying to say that Lily is a bad player. No. at all. She is perfect developer, but we as managers simply forgot to share with her idea that her knowledge is needed for everyone in our working community. That it may happen that she will need to share it with the wider community, and actually, this leadership on her side, it's about person able to onboard newcomers, able to raise successors, able to lead in a team. We may have a different case here when Lily will decide to make some task very deep, and we'll need more people to help her and to work in parallel. And I suspect that we'll have the same situation here. And even with not very sociable people like Lily here, it may be possible to make agreement. It's always possible to make agreement when you're explaining the idea of why we need it. How to explain this idea? Actually, we will talk a bit later during this presentation. And now it's time for me to introduce myself. I would like to start from the parallels with our heroes. I was Anna when tried to prove that my company must take care about one of our components. I prepared long documentation describing the benefits of investment into my idea, tried to gain more attention, and finally came out with a solution with the description in money language, because that was that top management understood. I had Anna in my own team who did not sell his 3D solution. Actually, the solution was really brilliant, I think. It was very cheap, it was very easy to set up, and the only issue he had was his presentation, because he forgot to focus on this benefits. He was talking a lot about technologies. And I worked and still work with Lily, who faces some difficulties with sharing his and actually her knowledge. We have not only one Lily, and it happens that you have really a team of Lilies in some cases. I'm Olga, in the recent past team lead of game server developers in Netent. Before this I was working as developer, more than 7 years in information technologies, almost all this time write some sort of code on different levels and on different size, client side, server side, was working as Android developer, so I have really wide experience. And now I'm a technical product owner and tech lead of the Game Server framework. It's a framework in one of our components. That's actually the position I was fighting for, to attract the attention of top management team into the issue when we had the framework really running in production and nobody taking care about it. That was my Anna fight, I can say. And I successfully passed and applied leadership trainings, and still doing that and plan to do it in future. Actually, my goal is to raise management skills in parallel to technical skills. Let's go to the some solutions of our issues. What should we know and share with others when it comes to communication? That's something that most of developers may forget, even most of managers may forget when they are hiring new people. Nobody wants to destroy the entire system right after this person gets a new position. Just say to yourself, it may be obvious, but in some cases when newcomers come and they start doing some not really correct from the technical perspective actions, we may forget it, and we may be angry on them. Especially when we are developers, and it was like our child, but somebody was trying to make something bad to it. It's oh my god, oh. When it comes to unclear or not well-defined expectations, like Lily expected something from newcomers, and newcomers expected something from Lily or from us. It's 99% that these unclear presentations will be totally different in Lily's head, in newcomer's head, and in our as management team heads. People with different responsibilities, that's interesting, may have in some cases totally different points of view on the system or product or task. And the last one, I will just show you what does it mean. Let's take a look into these people. Let's imagine that we are on the island and we're trying to see somebody, something on the horizon, and we see the boat. But what we don't see that there is a person starving and dying on this boat. And at the same time, the same situations is in the in the head of this person in the boat. And it's really applies to our work, because when you don't share your expectations or don't share your knowledge, it's really high percentage that this person that you didn't communicate to will understand it by her way, based on her experience, her lifestyle and her life habits. It's really is. And actually, one of the principles on based on this is next. This is SMART principles. When I was preparing this presentation, I found that the MAP principle may be applied to two cases, actually, and Anna's and Lily's. So first of all, let's take a look into Anna's parts of MAP. Let's imagine that the company, the whole company, is a MAP. And how Anna may see this MAP? Working as a developer, even a really good developer with really deep technical expertise, he may see only few parts of MAP because he is a developer. He did not create this company. He did not, she did not. I'm boring a bit. She did not create this company. She did not sell this product. It means that her part is somewhere between sales, DevOps, QAs, and something like that. And here, let's take a look how top management see this map. It means that when Anna was trying to explain her idea, she forgot to focus on the entire picture and just focused on some small parts of this map, trying to prove that investment into some small seaport in this small part of map will be really useful. But if Anna chose the way of explanation, like this part of map is really crucial, it's in the middle of the map, and it's really important to have seaport here because trading routes will be established from here to the world map. Hey, this that top management may understand, because what top management see and what Anna forgot about, it's trading routes, external connections, landscape view of the world map, and in some cases they simply forgot to and or maybe have no time and to go deeply to some small part of map. They will always work with the whole picture. But this principle may work in different case. Let's imagine that this part of map, it's Lily's responsibility. And Lily's knowledge of this map, it's really brilliant. She is almost landlord here. You can imagine, Lily worked here for many years. She discovered most of these parts of the map, and she really developed this parts of the map. So she should know that. And she is, as I said, landlord. But let's take a look how newcomers may see her map. Something in between a few parts, and these parts are ruined with some incorrectly understood information. And that's why we failed, because Lily's map is far from newcomers' map. And our goal as a management team will be to explain Lily this principle, to explain Lily the needs of making a good top-down presentation for newcomers, and really explain her that newcomers need to be onboarded in any case, because without onboarding, newcomers will work on this version of MAP. Next principle is called matrix of clear or explained items. It's actually very simple, but in some cases we may forget about it. What is in base? We have two scales, clarity scale and explanation scale. I don't know how you can see it, maybe you will see it something like that. The point is that we are moving from the not clear things to very clear, or not clear to very clear, or and from not explain it at all to well explain it. And the best part is where everything is clear and explain it. Let's take a look into one example. For instance, what is not clear and not explained? When I created this presentation, I was trying to put here rocket science, but I suspected that someone may know rocket science. So just imagine that what is not clear and not explained to you is some science very far from your specialty. Like for me, it's biology. I didn't like it and I didn't understand it. So it's totally not clear, not explained for me. In some gray areas, we might have very clear by our habits, by our experience, but not explained because we don't need to have this explained. Like not to be late, not to damage another person's belongings, not to break the law. It's obvious we shouldn't break the law, especially on the new working place. What is explained but may not to be clear well? How the system works, how the product works for newcomers, how some unknown part of the code works. And what is clear and explained on the first time, it's working agreements, team agreements, actually everything that's quite simple to understand on the first day, and then it comes with one explanation and that's all. And our goal as a management team, actually, even if you are not manager, even if you try to explain your system or your idea, your goal is to move everything that you need, that you think is useful, to the part of this matrix where everything is clear and where everything is well explained. Because here will be result. And we are moving to the next part of some principles, and here is transparency of expectations. I will touch this question today. I would like to explain what I was talking about. Lily expected to have this newcomers really experienced already, and to get her ideas from the first word. And like, oh, okay, we got it. We'll go to work. Here is our feature. So is it brilliant? Yes. And she said, yeah. Oh my God, it's awesome. Because it was in her head. Newcomers expected to have some onboarding, like we need at least 2 weeks to try to make some failures, maybe to try on some stage environment, not to touch production, and maybe to try working from some simple tasks. And here we got a conflict, and in so many cases we may have a conflict here, and our goal, despite of our position, we may be top manager, just team lead, or even simple developer. Our goal is to have expectations crossed. Like Lily have the same expectations as newcomers. It comes right after the matrix of clarity, because this result may be achieved right after the talking about some issue, getting the feedback. Based on this feedback, talking once more, explaining, and after some tries, because person may not just take a naked theory and, oh, okay, I got it, I will go and do it. No, we cannot swim without practicing. Yes? Yes, we cannot code without practicing. We cannot do anything without practicing. That's what we may forget something sometimes. And it brings us to the next part of the presentation that that actually is important because explains why the people behave in some way. This is methodology, psychological methodology to divide people's behavior into some groups and to describe this behavior with the principles, and more important, to find some keys to work with these people. So let's take a look closer to these groups. Dominance, it's about people who are driving results, taking challenges. It's about leaders, about these leaders that going straight forward to the goal. Influence, it's about people who thinking about ideas, who thinking calm about people, listen more than talking, likes and enjoys communication. And these people are maybe good people managers, for instance. Compliance, important that on this part our girls are. It's logic, systems, and standards. It's about developers. It's about focusing on some result, but not only not only results straightforward, but on the ways how to achieve that. It's about implementing some systems, implementing some plans, about some structured behavior and structured way of thinking. And the last but not the least, not so interesting for our presentation right now, it's steadiness. It's about people who works and enjoys safety, predictability, who as well like communication and what's more important, knows how to do it in a correct way. But I would like to talk more about compliance, because most technical people are here, and this brings us to the need to work with them, to educate them, and to know how to make mistakes with them. What compliance people don't like most? They don't like rule breakers. They don't like people who doesn't keep a distance. It's like this close communication, this hugging, this very close people attraction, trying to ask you how was your day, are you okay, why are you so sad, something like that. They don't like frequent interaction with other people without goal, but just simple communication, blah blah blah, what did you do, blah blah blah, I did, okay, did you see that person, did you see what she's wearing, oh my god, it's not about them. It means that this way of behavior will not bring us to the goal to be closer with them. These people don't like to focus on something outside the problem. They focus on the problem and how to work with them and how actually to build communication with them. It's simple. Show logical steps and consequences. Be patient and speak without generalization, without these general ideas we'll live in some bright world. No, it's concrete cases. We need to work with newcomers. You will need to explain this to the people. You need to understand that the language you use in top management with the top management is not the correct, because they will not understand you, and there is high chance that they will not take you seriously, something like that. Be factual, that's important, and give enough time to formulate a plan, because what is important about these people, they are working by some plan. And I would like to have a few remarks about DISC. Actually, DISC is a methodology that cannot be included into 40-minute session. It's something that you can talk about for a day, to talk in theory, to try and practice, to try this capacity test on yourself. I'm here just touching this question to give you some overview and to make you be interested in that, at least to Google it and to try to apply it on your work. This methodology is not about dividing people. It's just working. It's just working tool for finding the correct way to communicate with different people. It's about when you think about interaction with the people as a leader, you will understand that you need to find the key to every person to work with every people with very different ones. The behavior, of course, the behavior, because this is behavioral tool, maybe adopted and natural. Here we are not talking about natural behavior, because at home people may be very different from the working environment. Here we're working on talking about only working behavior and habits. So don't think that our girls are so technical at home. No, they may be totally different people. They are just here, straightforward and compliant here at work. And the DISC is quite complex and takes some time and money, but it definitely worth it. We'll try to do it in our work, and I read much about using it on different companies. Okay, so what's next? How to help my team to succeed? Okay, I know about Matrix, I know about MAP, how to do it. Like, you cannot go simply to go to some person and say, let me explain you something. Let me explain you how our system works, for instance, from top level to bottom. No, you need to build some trust. And I would like to divide this information into two parts, because here we are working with the two cases, like management case and teammate case. So for the management case and for actually the team leads, tech leads, the people who need to gather people around their ideas. First of all, what you need, you should build the trust between you and the person by recurrent one-on-one meeting. I was trying to do it when I thought that I need some successor. I was trying to do it by actually sharing this information, this very this information with my teammate who was really not so open for communication, and he didn't know how to do it in the correct way. He wanted to do, but sometime he may do a really funny mistakes with the communication. What do you want from me, or something like that, or did you see this part of code? It's not the way to give feedback. So we are trying to learn how to give feedback. It brings us to the next point. It's mentorship opportunities for your employees within the teams. After we passed some one-on-one meetings with this person, I gave him mentorship opportunities to work with another developer, to share his experience, to try to be responsible on the work of his teammate, and actually to try to explain the system, the technology, the ways of coding, code standards, the consequences, what is that is important, why we have code standards, rules of work, and something like that. And the last but not the least here is public speaking trainings and internal events. Internal events is a very good way to train public speaking habits or public speaking public speaking experience. Yes, I found the correct word. After almost 40 minutes, I'm starting to forget some English words. that's if we are managers. But even when we want to help our teammate to succeed, or even want to raise successor in our own team, being a team member, we may help him or her with the permanent feedbacks, with the public speaking trainings where we all attended together, with the sharing the ideas in the close group, like, Anna, let's try to do it together, and then you will have an experience, you will feel like how is it to share your idea, you will think about the result, possible consequences, and maybe your result will be better next time when you'll go to the wider gathering. It's about knowledge sharing sessions, like I will share how I work and you will share your technical details. Maybe in some cases, if it's possible, on one day we'll try to exchange our roles and I will be developer in one area, you will be developer in another area, or even when it comes to different competences, it's even better. And actually, that's all for today from me. And what I'd like to say as an afterword is that my goal was to find some of your pains and to show that even with the simple actions, we may change a thing. And if some idea touched you and you want to try it, so it's really time to try. The worst that you will have that you will have no results. But when you will try and you will see some feedback, there is a really high chance that you will actually see the result, and it's really cool. And I would like to say thank you to my very best friend, Daria Skripnik, who created our girls, our prototypes. And now I can close my presentation and go to the window with your questions, with your thoughts, and with everything. As if I understand you correctly, we are lack of time. If you have any questions, feel free to reach me in the LinkedIn. I'll be networking somewhere around here in the event. And let me check just a few seconds. Are there any questions? You are free to ask. I'll be glad to help you. And thank you for your thoughts here. Thank you for being with me today. It was really nice to be with you.